In this video, let's learn how to use brush textures, also called alphas, to sculpt fur in Blender. Alphas are grayscale images with depth information that we can attach to the sculpting brushes to quickly sculpt details and speed up the entire sculpting process. You can of course not only sculpt fur with this technique, but anything you can imagine, from skin details to cracks or even attachments like bolts. However, here let's learn this technique by sculpting fur. By the way, you can download our 24 free fur alphas in our free resource section. Only an email is required to sign up, link down below in the video description. And this video here is part of my updated Blender sculpting course, so if you want to learn everything you need to know about sculpting in Blender, you can find the link to the course down below in the video description. Yeah, my name is Zach Reinhardt for ggboost.com, and now let's get started. So for everyone that don't want to watch a long video, here is a quick summary in less than 1 minute. For sculpting with alphas, a very high resolution mesh is helpful, so I recommend using the multi-res modifier for best results. Then in sculpt mode, go to the texture tab, make sure brush is selected, then click on new, rename the texture slot and open the fur alpha you downloaded from our free resource section. Enable non-color for the color space, then to add more alphas, enable fake users so the image will stay connected in the blend file. Then click the X up here and repeat the same process. Then use a sculpt drop brush, go to texture in the brush settings, click the image to choose the alpha you want to use for sculpting. Change the mapping to area plane so the alpha will be projected on the surface according to the surface normal. In the stroke settings, change the stroke method to anchored. Now you can add the fur onto the surface by scaling it from the center of the brush. Enable edge to edge if you rather want to scale it from one edge to the other. Change the fall off to constant to not lose details of the fur texture at the edges of the brush. Adjust the strength of the brush and have fun sculpting the fur. And now let's have a look on how all this works in detail. So before we import the images, let's have a quick look at the scene I have here. I'm using Blender 3.0 alpha, as you can see down here. I have this reference image open to see how the fur will look like, and I used grease pencil to draw a fur reference onto the surface of the creature here, which helps me to define the flow of the fur. Then for the creature itself, I added a multi-res modifier. That means if I disable this, the base mesh here has a pretty good topology. That means the multi-res modifier is subdividing the mesh quite nicely. That means if I enable wireframe here, you can see that we have a pretty high resolution with a decent subdivision. Actually, the resolution is even higher here. This, as you can see, and this allows us to add pretty nice details to the surface by using the alphas. And by using the multi-res modifier instead of, for example, dynamic topology, the performance of the viewport will be much, much better. So sculpting with alphas with dynamic topology is not recommended. Yeah, and if I switch over to sculpt mode, I also have drawn some mask around some areas which I don't want to affect with my fur brush. For example, here on the horns, around the mouth, the eyes, and the nose. And currently, as you can see, when I navigate, the resolution is changing. That's because up here under options, I enabled fast navigate. This option only works with a multi-res modifier. If you don't like this, you can of course turn it off. If you have a strong machine, then it also works without this. Yeah. And now let's get into using the alphas. All right, now let's add some textures. You can see I'm here in sculpt mode. Let's go down to the texture tab. Make sure that brush is selected up here and click on new. Then we create a new empty texture slot. Let's call it fur01 and then click on open and navigate to the folder where you downloaded the textures which are attached to this lesson here. So here you can see we have a bunch of textures, and if you want to see the preview images, click on this icon up here. And then you can see I created always two versions of one brush, the A and the B. And you can see the A one has less details and the B version has more details. So it depends on how you want to have the look of the creature. And you can see we have some patches here. We have thicker and shorter fur alphas, and we also have longer or medium long alphas. So I think I go with the less detailed version, this one here. So I click on one and click on open image. Now this image is attached to this fur texture slot. So the texture slot and the image itself are two different things here in Blender. One thing I do now is to click this shield icon for both the texture slot and for the image. So that means if I remove this texture here, and if I would now create a new one, the other one would still stay here. Even if we save, close and reopen Blender, then we don't lose this texture in this file. Also make sure that under File, External Data, Automatically Pack Resources is enabled. Then these textures will be packed into this blend file as well. Of course, only if you want to do this, otherwise they will be just linked into your file and will stay on your hard drive. So, and one other thing we need to do is to change the color space from sRGB to non-color. I can't explain you exactly what is going on behind the scenes here because color management is a very complicated topic. However, we need to do this in order to get all the information out of this image for the sculpting process. So when sRGB is selected here, you can see that the image looks a bit different, and then we don't get the right height information which are stored in this image here. So just make sure to switch this to non-color down here to have accurate results. So, what if you want to add more images? For that, as mentioned, enable the shield, remove this, create a new texture slot, call it Fur 02 for example, and let's open another one. So I had this Fur 2A if I remember correctly. Let's pick the 3A, again enable the shield here and change this to non-color up here as well. Then let's remove this one and create another one. Fur 3, open, and let's scroll down here. I think I pick the Fur 1A, which is the straight version. Then let's enable the shield and change this to non-color. And maybe let's add one fur patch. So let's remove this one here. Let's call it Fur Patch 01, for example. Open, and in this case, let's take, I think this one here, open image. Then enable the shield and let's change this to non-color. All right, now we have imported the textures and now let's see how we can attach them to the brushes. By the way, if you want to have a greater variety of fur alphas, they are great sculpting alpha picks on the Blender market, for example. I will link at least one down below in the video description. Of course, these cost some money, but they might be worth it if you are using these textures a lot. And maybe you can even find some free ones online. So, now let's go up here to the brush settings. And of course, we can attach the textures to any brush we have here. However, I feel that the Sculpt Draw brush is probably the best one to add a texture to make it work properly. So, under the brush settings tab, we can find the texture. And now, if we click on the image here, you can see that we have all these different fur brushes here to choose from. Now there are two major areas where we need to change something, which is the texture settings here and the stroke settings. So for the texture settings, right now the mapping is set to tiled, which will basically, if I increase the brush here, just give us a fixed placement of these brushes in space, which is of course not what is useful for us right now. So let's change the mapping to area plane. That means it will detect the surface, similar as the brush is moving across the surface, and will place the brush correctly on the different spot on the surface. However, as you can see right now, we are just drawing a line of the fur, which is of course not what we want. So let's go down to the stroke settings, and first of all, let's switch to the anchored stroke method, which I find is the best one for working with alphas. And now if I left click and hold and drag, we can drag this here onto the surface, and by moving the mouse, we can rotate it or scale it. Right now it's starting from the center and is scaling up. However, if you don't like this behavior, you can also go from edge to edge, which basically scales along the mouse movement, as you can see. So this is working nicely already, as you can see. However, we still don't have the full information here because the falloff is set to smooth. You can see this little curve here, and imagine this is our brush strength from viewing it from the side. That means when we are now sculpting, it is basically taking away strength from the texture on the edges here. So actually the tip of the fur is higher. By the way, let's maybe disable the fast navigate option here. I don't really need it. And then it's always switching to the low resolution, which is a bit unuseful by showcasing this here. So in order to get all the information from the image which we attach to the brush, go to fall off and change this to constant. Now you can see from this edgy shape here that basically everything will be 100% included in the texture. So to better illustrate this, if I remove the texture here and now just do a simple brush stroke, you can see it's just one flat shape. And if I look from the side, you can see this is the same shape as we can see up here. If I switch back to smooth, for example, and maybe make the strength stronger, you can see this is now this exact shape here. And imagine the texture is projected inside here, and then of course at the edges it will be cut off, and over here it won't be cut off because everything is included. So let's undo all this here. Let's pick one of the textures again and make sure the fall off is set to constant. So now we can basically start sculpting. Okay, well, not with that strong brush, of course. Here we first need to check how strong we want to make the brush. Yeah, I think something like 0.3 something works nicely for this brush. So now if you want to change the texture, simply switch this over here and then we can draw here. And by using this edge-to-edge method, you really have to get used to where to start with your brush placement, because it is also moving down a bit. So for example, when I start over here, I can place it pretty much directly down here. So, and here I can also show you the big downside of using these textures. You can get these very ugly overlapping here, something like this. And this doesn't look good. And this is usually the reason why I choose to sculpt the fur manually, because it also takes a bit of practice to place all these fur elements at the right spot. And of course, it is definitely possible. And as you can imagine, this can highly speed up the whole process, probably only taking half an hour instead of 5 hours manually sculpting the fur. So let's undo this stuff here. There is another stroke method you can use, which maybe is not good for anything, but maybe it can help sometimes. Down here under stroke, let's change the stroke method back to space. Let's increase the spacing to something like 50% or 60%. Make sure jitter is disabled down here. And then we can basically draw a line of these fur elements. Now you can see they are still too close together. So maybe let's try 60%, still a bit close. Maybe 70. Yeah, I think 70 is good. And now you can see when I move in a different direction, they will always point down. This can be useful, but I don't like this behavior. Let's go up here to the texture settings and enable rake. This allows us to make the texture follow our mouse cursor movement, which is pretty cool. And to add a bit more variety, let's also enable random. Then we get a random rotation for each placement of the texture here. However, right now it would rotate between 0 and 360 degrees. I don't want this too much, so maybe let's try 50 degrees. And then you can see that there's a little bit of random rotation inside of these textures. So this might help to like quickly add some brush strokes here on the back. Maybe leave a little bit space in between, and then you can also switch back to the anchored method down here and then add a few of these brushes in between here, and of course change between the different textures so that you have a bit of variety here. Something like this. Yeah, and this is basically all you need to know about using these alphas for sculpting. And of course, similar for the manual sculpting process, when you are too close to the symmetry line here, disable symmetry to add some non-symmetrical shapes here at the center. Yeah, and now let's undo this. And now I think in this case, let's disable the fur reference. I roughly know where and how I want to place the fur. Then let's press Control Space to full screen the 3D view. Press N, and here under Tool, we can also find all the sculpting tools and also the textures, as you can see. Maybe let's disable the navigate gizmo and also the red x-axis down here. I just want to have the window a bit more clean, because now you can enjoy a quick time lapse where I sculpt the fur with this method here on the head of the creature. Have fun! So, and this here is my result after 30 minutes of sculpting. And I think using this method, it's pretty decent. It looks very clean since we have these harsh lines. We can clearly see the individual hair strands. And I think overall it looks pretty good. So what I did here, I created these bigger shapes first. However, then I realized I have a lot of little empty spaces in between because I took care that I don't overlap these fur strands too much because otherwise this would look awful. And then in a second pass, I went through here and created these little hair strands in between where we had empty space. And then I used the draw sharp brush and created some sharp lines here and there to like better connect everything with each other. So I could have done this even further, of course. And with a nudge brush, I could like still shape the flow of the hair or of the fur a bit better if I like, which is pretty nice. One thing I realized is when using these alpha textures, it is pretty good to have your hand always at Control Z to undo, because sometimes you have like one of these strokes and then you want to place another one, but you realized you place it too high, then undo it, try it again until you get the right spot. So it's a little bit of practice to understand how the brush behaves, but yeah, using Control Z is really a helpful thing when sculpting with alphas. Yeah, I hope you found this video helpful and learned a thing or two. If you want to learn more about sculpting and how to create this entire creature from scratch, check out my updated Blender sculpting course at academy.ctboost.com, link down below in the video description. Thanks a lot for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Goodbye.